all heaven and the unfallen worlds, had witnessed the controversy. With intense interest, they followed the closing scenes. They beheld the Savior enter the Garden of Gethsemane, his soul weighed down with the horror of great darkness. They heard his bitter cry, "Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me." As the Father's presence was withdrawn, they saw him sorrowful, with a bitterness of sorrow, exceeding that of his last great struggle with death. The bloody sweat was forced from his pores, and fell in drops upon the ground. Three times, the prayer for deliverance was wrung from his lips. Heaven could no longer endure the sight, and a messenger was sent to the Son of God. Heaven beheld the victim, betrayed into the hands of the murderous mob, and with violence and mockery, hurried from one tribunal to another. It saw the frenzied work of Satan, and his power over the hearts of men. O fearful scene, the Savior seized at midnight in Gethsemane, dragged to and fro, from palace to judgment hall, arraigned two times before the priest, twice before Pilate, and once before Herod. Mocked, scourged, condemned, and led out to be crucified, bearing the heavy burden of the cross. Amid the wailing of the daughters of Jerusalem, and the jeering of the crowd, heaven saw with grief and amazement, Christ hanging upon the tree, blood flowing from his wounded temples, and sweat tinged with blood, standing upon his brow. From his hands and feet, the blood falling drop by drop upon the rocks at the foot of the cross. Think about Jesus, as the wounds made by the nails gaped, as the weight of his body dragged upon his hands. His labored breath grew quick and deep, as his soul panted under the burden of the sins of the world. Think about Jesus, offering a prayer amid his terrible suffering, saying, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." While men, formed in the image and likeness of God, stood by and joined in to crush the life of the only begotten Son of God.